Alright everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today is the vlog for Crystal Palace against Southampton at Selhurst Park, kickoff at 7:30. I'm quite optimistic for this one because Southampton, 3-0 loss against Arsenal at the weekend, 16th in the Premier League, whereas Palace, 13th in the Premier League, brilliant win over Everton on Sunday. Go check out the vlog if you haven't already. I'm predicting a nice comfortable 3-0 win for Crystal Palace here. I think will pose a good threat to Southampton, and Southampton I've heard are quite injury stricken at the moment, so yeah, I think all is in our favour for this one. Let's go to Selhurst and see if Palace can get the result I want. Come on!
I just said bollocks. I said alright, fuck it, I'm not going here. Can't bother the argument, do you know what I mean? Then she said go, I said see you later.
As you saw there, free kick goal 1-1, James Ward-Prowse, what a free kick, 1-1. Ever since we went 1-0 up, we've been absolutely shocking. 2-1 Southampton, bro, yeah. It just takes it, bottom left. No chance for Butland. I mean, both goals, he's had no chance. 2-1 Southampton, two goals in the space of like 4 minutes. This has been absolutely shocking. Absolutely shocking. Half time, 2-1 to Southampton. Went 1-0 up inside 2 minutes. Goal from Wilfried Zaha. Then a brilliant free kick from Ward-Prowse that I actually managed to film. And then Broya with a brilliant strike into the bottom left-hand corner. I know that people are going to be blaming Vieira for picking Jack Butland, but he couldn't do anything about them two goals. Midfield have been absolutely shocking today so far. I'd be happy with the point the way we've been playing. Come on, Palace. Let's pull this back. We have before. It's 2-2. I'm going to say it. 2-2. Jordan Ayew. His first goal in quite a while. His first goal in a year. 2-1. 2-1. 2-2. Against Ranta, I'm not taking that result. But where I've been playing, I think I'll be happy with that point. 2-2. Come on, Palace. So we're back from Selhurst Park full-time, Crystal Palace 2, Southampton 2. To be fair, the way we played, it's a point that I'm proud of. I'll take a draw. Ever since going 1-0 up in the first 2 minutes, Southampton were the much better side, controlling possession. And then they got the well-deserved goal. Goal from James Ward-Prowse, free kick. And then Broya scored 4 minutes after the equaliser to make it 2-1 at half time. Then Jordan Ayew got his first goal for 13 months with a nice finish from a tight angle to make it 2-2. No, I haven't really, didn't really have much to say in the second half. Not really much to say. No chances either end. Romeu for Southampton had a chance right at the end and he put it over the bar. That's probably the only chance that any side had after Ayew's equaliser. So we've gone from 13th to 11th in the Premier League. Now, guys, obviously, as we all know, COVID's on the rise. I don't know whether this is going to be my last vlog for a while, because obviously they might cut off football matches, or they might be playing behind closed doors, but like before. So Palace's next scheduled game is Watford at Vicarage Road on Saturday. However, Watford's game against Burnley was called off due to Watford players having COVID. So I don't think this game will go ahead, because I don't think Watford players, just because they're footballers, I don't think they're going to get over COVID in 3 days. I don't think it's going to happen. So yeah, hopefully it does happen though, so I can keep you guys updated on the channel. And yeah, so Palace are 11th in the league, decent position. The thing is, right, we've played 17 games, we've only lost 5. I think that's a very, very good record for the club to hold. And yeah, it's the end of the video, guys. Like, share and subscribe. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the near future.